Let us talk about user-defined functions. Thus far, we have used functions provided by the C standard library like printf, scanf and square root. It is very much possible to write our own functions to do whatever work we need. What are functions? Functions are a group of instructions that have a name. You can think of a function as a small program with its own declarations, its own code, okay, and its own programming logic. Functions are very important because we take a large problem and divide it into smaller parts, and then we solve the bigger problem by joining the smaller parts to form the solution of the complete problem. The advantage of dividing a bigger problem into a smaller manageable parts is it becomes easy to understand, the modification or maintenance is easy, and then it can be reused in different places as and when you require to be used. So let's try to understand functions through a simple example. So here I have a code to find the sum of two numbers. For now, skip on this part. We'll start taking a look at this one. It starts with the int main function, which we have been using so far. I have declared variables. Int a is assigned the value 10, b is assigned the value 20, and the third variable called as answer, which is not given any value. Then I'm saying answer is assigned the value sum of a comma b. So now sum happens to be a user defined function. After the sum calculates the value of x plus y, I am printing the value of sum here. So let us first try to understand the basic building blocks of the function. Now, in order to calculate the sum, I have written a function called as int sum, okay, which accepts two parameters x and y. Everything will be clear in a short while. So this code between this flower brace happens to be the definition of the function or the function code. All right. Now here sum a comma b is a call to this particular function. When this thing is called, the values of a get copied to x, the value of b gets copied to y. You need to understand a is in a different memory location, x is a different memory location, b is a different memory location, y is a different memory location. Then what I am doing here is I am adding the result of x plus y and using a return statement. So what will happen is the sum of a plus b, which was copied into x and y respectively, will get added and the result will get assigned to answer. Suppose a is 10 and b is 20, x would have been 10 and y would have been 20. 10 plus 20 would have been 30. So answer would have been 30 and the result of this printf result would have been printed as 30. Now the a and b here, which are used in main to send the values to x and y respectively, these are known as the actual arguments or the actual parameters. X and y are known as the formal arguments or the formal parameters. Now, if you see here, x and y are integers. Answer is also an integer. I am returning a value which is of the type integer. That's why I am saying this function returns an integer type of value. Int means this function sum int x comma int y returns an integer value through this return statement, which is copied to answer. I have already told you about a and b. These are parameters in main. These are formal parameters in sum. Okay, so this is the way you declare them. Int is x is integer, y is also integer. Now let's try to understand through one more example all the different particular aspects. Now if you see here in this particular program, I am trying to print a simple greeting with the name of a function called as say namaskar. So I have declared a function called as main void. Now you need to understand main is also a function, just as sum or say namaskar is a function. Void means main is not accepting any parameters. If you see here sum was accepting two parameters x and y. You can also send parameters or values to main, but I choose not to send. That's why this void indicates no values are being sent to main by the user. Now, when I say namaskar void, what I am doing is I am invoking this particular function say namaskar. Void indicates that nothing is parameter or nothing is being sent from main to this particular function say namaskar. This is not accepting any parameter. That means no data is being transferred from here to here. Then what is happening in say namaskar is I am simply printing the message namaskar and I am coming back to return. Since this say namaskar is not returning any value, that's why I have given it the return type as void. Here I was returning an integer data, that's why I said int. Here I am returning nothing, that's why I say void. Here I am not passing any parameter, that's why it is void. Okay, so this should hopefully help you understand the fundamental building blocks of what exactly is a function. Now, if you have to look at the general template of a function, the general template of a function is going to look something like this. The function will have a return type. In this case, it was int, here it was void. Function name, here it was sum, here it was say namaskar. Parameters, here it was x and y, here it was no parameters. Declarations, okay, I have not declared any variables here, but the function can have its own variables like I, J, K, whatever it is. So I don't have any declarations. Code, the code here happens to be return x plus y, the code here happens to be print namaskar. So return type is compulsory. That means if it is returning int, you have to say int. If it is returning float data type, you have to say float. If it is not returning anything, you have to say clearly void. Okay, void in parameters, okay, is a good practice like this, where I am not sending any parameters between this main to any other function. It is good practice to indicate by void, although void is optional. This indicates that there is no data communication between this function to, sorry, from the main to this. In this case, AB is communicating with XY. In this case, there is no data transfer between main to say namaskar. So just to help you understand this AB and XY, you can think of AB as one location. So this is A, this is B. Think of this as in 1000th location, this as in 1004. You can think of X and Y in two different memory locations. This is in location 2000 and 2004. So the value of A gets copied to X, the value of B gets copied to Y. So if you do any changes in X and Y here, it is not going to affect A and B, because A and B happen to be in different memory locations. So I hope this helps you get a decent idea about what really are functions. So just to let you know, printf and scanf, two are functions which have been written by experts of C programming, so that all of us could use and go ahead and do our programming jobs.